do today is expose the real haters.
There's a new sheriff in town, and his name is Donald Trump.
You're brainwashed by the media, the real fake news.
I tell you, President Trump, build that wall.
Let it be known that if God is your enemy, you have the most powerful enemy in the world, in the universe.
Regardless if you're Democrat or Republican, you're going to bow your knee one day.
Amen. Fight as you will for liberalism. Fight as you will for the devil. But one day it's gonna end. There is a day of wrath, a day of righteous indignation. There is a day where the holy God will cast away from him every one of his enemies. And if you're a sinner today, if you love sin, you are an enemy of God.
In this country, you have a right to peacefully assemble. You got a right to peacefully assemble, but you don't have a right to resist the duly appointed elected government. Before God Almighty, you're a rebel and you're headed for hell if you come against the ordinances of God. If you assemble to resist the fight to bring down the government, you're a rebel. Rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft. You're practicing witchcraft. If you want to bring down the government of the United States,
let's get back to a nation of laws. Did anybody ever ask Mexico why they built their southern wall to keep people out? Does anybody ask Canada why they do extreme vetting from America to Canada? But no, you want radical Islam in this nation. And I say, Democrats, liberals, is a mental disorder. How can you vote for abortion for people that will chop your heads off?
If God is your enemy, you have absolutely zero hope in judgment, in the judgment day. On judgment day, if you appear before him unholy and unrighteous as you are in your sins, there is no hope. And he will say these terrifying, horrifying words that will echo in your ears throughout all eternity. Away from me, I never knew you, you worker of iniquity.
You want to bring Sharia law to the American shores. That is just absolutely absurd. It's insanity. I tell you, Trump is the best thing that has happened to this nation since Ronald Reagan.
That's right. Thank you.
And I'm not saying that Trump can fix all the problems. The only person that can fix the problems is Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Almighty God. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. Regardless if you're Democrat or Republican, you're going to bow your knee one day.
Amen.
You better do it now, because the next time on Judgment Day, you're going to be cast into hell fire.
We put up with Obama for 8 years. We didn't resist. We didn't put on pig hats and a bunch of women marching in the street. We didn't tear down Berkeley when Obama was president. So now that Trump's president, he's our president, he's your president. And you don't have a right before God Almighty to resist the powers that be. You need to read your Bible. Romans chapter 13, verses 1 and 2, it's right there. Whoever resists the power resists the ordinance of God and shall receive damnation. If you come against the duly elected government, you're a rebel headed for hellfire.
God says he hates hands that shed innocent blood. That's one thing he states very specifically. And it doesn't get any more innocent than an unborn child. It doesn't get any more innocent than killing a child still in the womb, which must be the safest place on earth, is actually the most dangerous. The most dangerous spot to be on this earth is inside your mother's womb. You see, you can talk about the Holocaust. Everybody always talks about Nazis nowadays. It confuses me a little bit. You want to complain about Hitler and all that he did and the people he killed and whatnot. Yet the American Holocaust makes Hitler's Holocaust look like kindergarten. The Holocaust happened in Planned Parenthood today makes Hitler's Holocaust look like small game.
You're the real hater. You who live in sin and teach others to do so, you're the real hater. Yep. And you know what? You people hate holiness. You hate righteousness. Anybody who hates holiness, who hates righteousness, and sticks up for sin and loves sin is the real hater. Because sin is the way of death. Sin, if you're in sin, you're a child of the devil. If you're a party animal, you're a child of the devil. And don't you dare try to stand up and say that you are a loving person when you are encouraging this society to live in rebellion against holiness, rebellion against righteousness, rebellion against the Almighty Blessed God. The Bible says that the greatest commandment there is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength. And incidentally, if you are in rebellion to this commandment, there is no obedience to the other nine. If you got this right, if you loved the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, you wouldn't be lying, you wouldn't be stealing, you wouldn't be committing adultery, you wouldn't propagate homosexuality. The only source of living water is Jesus Christ. The only thing that can save America is Jesus Christ. And so, America, it is time to put away these devilish protests against what is righteous and good. It's time to put away these protests that propagate lawlessness and rebellion.
CNN, NBC, CBS, MSNBC, that's the fake news, and they're brainwashing you. You're brainwashed by MTV. You're brainwashed by the academia, the schools, the educational system, the universities. And our own government has brainwashed you. You people are under mind control. Don't you know this country's going to be destroyed if you don't get behind our president? You're a bunch of rebels! You got a right to peacefully assemble, that's all right, but you don't have a right to take down the government. And that's what George Soros wants to do. And you're a bunch of minions of George Soros if he pays you 15 bucks an hour to go rip up the street like Berkeley. Time to repent, America. It's time to put away your rebellion. It's time to humble yourself, get right with God Almighty. Repent of your sins and trust Jesus Christ to save your soul from sin and hell. He's a good God. Amen. If you humble yourself like a little child, instead of being proud and arrogant, thinking you can take down the country, humble yourself, cry out to mercy. God's a good God. He'll see your heart, and he'll save your soul.
You know what? I'm really not impressed. I thought there would be more intelligence. I thought we might encounter some intelligent life down here. I guess I was mistaken. Of course I was mistaken. How intelligent could a liberal be anyway? Liberals are pretenders. Liberals are pretenders. They pretend there's no God. They pretend there's no judgment day. They don't live in reality. They pretend that Donald Trump is not our president. Not our president. You don't live in reality. You're a bunch of pretenders. You're a bunch of pretenders. It's time to live in reality. Donald Trump is president. Stop pretending that he's not your president. But greater than that, God Almighty will judge you, sinner. God Almighty will judge all of you. And no amount of pretending will take away Judgment Day. No amount of pretending can take away the decree of God. The soul that sins, it will die. You, ma'am, you're going to die. You're going to die in your sins. You're going to go to hell. That's right. You're going to hell. That's right. You're going down. You're going down to hell. That's right. You know what your problem is? You're a hater. You hate truth. You hate reality. Reality is a nightmare to you. You know why? Because you can't live with yourself. Reality is a nightmare to you pretenders, you liberals. You can't live with yourself because your conscience condemns you. Because you're living in rebellion to God. You're living in rebellion to the blessed Lord. You know what peace would be? You know what peace would be? If people would obey God. If people would obey the commandments of God. So we're calling people to live for the greatest cause that there is, the only worthy cause that there is to live for. You see, the Bible says that we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. That means there is a death sentence passed upon humanity because God is a just God. He will punish sinners wherever they are. Whatever your sin is, it doesn't matter if you're a homosexual or a porno freak or you just like Playboy magazine, you're going to be judged in that day. And so, those that have sinned against God are under a death sentence, and that sentence is already passed. His wrath already abides upon you, sinner. And now the only way of escape is the mercy of a God who so loved you, the Bible says, he gave his only begotten Son. And the conditions to receive Jesus Christ are not out of reach for anybody. The Bible says that those that believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. To believe is to follow. To believe is to obey. To believe is to be loyal, to be married to Jesus Christ. So if you say, well, I'm good, I'm a Christian, but you're still living in willful sin, I got news for you. The Bible says not everyone that says to me, Lord, Lord, will inherit the kingdom of heaven, but only those that do the will of God. So America, it's time to repent. Jesus said it this way, repent or perish. And I'm going to believe the words of Jesus over the words of the vain philosophers of this age who say, oh, transgenderism or homosexuality, they're not even a mental condition now. They're saying that it's normal. You know what's wrong? You know what's wrong with you people? When you form your opinions, you leave God out of it. God doesn't influence your opinions at all. That's what's wrong with you. You omit God from everything, and now you're left to be ravaged by the devil. I'm surprised that your thinking becomes so corrupt. I'm not surprised that your mind is growing darker, that your life is growing more rebellious, that you're becoming more like the devil every day. I'm not surprised, because when you forsake God, when you say, throw God's commandments behind your back, then you're left to be ravaged by the devil. What else is there? If you abandon God, if you abandon Jesus Christ, you abandon absolute truth. The Bible says God is love. So if you turn your back on God, you're turning your back on love. Don't tell me that you're a loving person when you've turned your back on God. Like sinners love to quote, God is love. Okay, if God is love, then what does that mean about you when you live in rebellion to Him? That means you are not, you don't know anything about love. You're a hater. You're the real hater. You who have abandoned God, you who throw absolute truth behind your back. You know, the Bible says God is love. God is truth. God is the way, the truth, and the life. And so when you turn your back on God, on Jesus Christ, you're saying that truth and love mean nothing to you.
What is that little tent city thing that got?
So who are the real haters? You who live in sin. You who live in rebellion to God. It's time to serve the blessed God. There's no one better. No one I'd rather die for, no one I'd rather live for than the lovely Jesus Christ, who gave His life for me, who commanded His life toward me while I was yet a sinner. The Bible says He died for me. And now He said this, have faith, come unto me, all ye who are burdened and heavy laden, I will give you rest. So I want to conclude my message with this. Jesus is not just the Savior of the Republicans and the Savior of those that voted for Trump. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the whole world. For libertarians and Democrats and Republicans, every tribe, every language. I'm not saying that your political views wouldn't change if you repented. I'm not saying you could be a Democrat and go to heaven. I'm saying that Jesus Christ died for the sins of everyone. Why would you take up this cause to live in anarchy and rebellion against God when God's inviting you to come to the foot of the cross and have your sins cleansed? You know why it is? Oh, that command to repent. I have to give up my life. I have to give up myself. That's right. Don't bother coming to God if you're not ready to give Him everything. But if you're willing to give God everything, He's willing to give you everything He is. So I urge everyone not to let this fall on deaf ears. How many more times will you get the call to repentance? We don't know. Some have passed on to eternity. Some of your ancestors have passed on to eternity, leaving the call to repentance unnoticed and died in their sins. And right now they're crying out in everlasting torment and hoping that some of His later generation, those that are coming behind Him, might be more wise than what He has been. So repent, America.